They have the steering wheel. They have the gears. They have the clutch. They have the brake. They decide the direction also. Only the make of tires, whether MRF or CN, is done by the LG. And if still you cannot drive, then there is something seriously wrong with your driving ability.
Because ultimately, you
and another proposal
is done by the Chief Minister.
No, nothing inconvenient will come. You can sit.
I'm saying nothing. I'm just. You are the one who's speaking.
But another thing. But I come to another limb of my submission. Another indication that persons working in the Union Territory are working in the affairs of the Union. No, now Administrative Tribunal.
You know, Mr. I'm sorry, I'm eating into your time, but there's only one aspect, that is 309 gives power to the Union Government to regulate all terms and conditions of service of officers who are appointed in connection with the affairs of the Union. Would it possibly be that, I mean, your argument would be that affairs of the Union in Article 309 would mean the entirety of the affairs of the Union Territory, including all services. The other countervailing argument could be that affairs of the Union in Article 309 should include those matters which are entrusted to the Union by 239AA. One way of looking at it is look the entirety of the canvas of a Union Territory of Delhi, notwithstanding 239AA, is an affair of the Union, because the Union has jurisdiction on list 1, list 2, and list 3.
Therefore.
But that is subject again, subject.
Therefore.
It's a little bit.
Your lordships have in mind.
309 also subject.
Lord, your lordships have in mind. But the position, my lord, which is
takes us to
portray. Let me demolish, my lord, fully crafted perception that we have no power. Let me demolish that. Then your lordships may examine, my lord, these legal provisions in that context.
Yes.
But para 27. The yes. Administrative Tribunal Act is enacted in exercise of the powers under Article 323A of the Constitution. The said article provides that the Parliament may make law constituting tribunals of disputes and complaints with respect to recruitment and conditions of service of persons appointed to public services and posts in connection with the affairs of the Union and another, my lord, affairs of the state. Now, my lords, may kindly come to Section 14 of the Administrative Tribunals. Jurisdiction, powers, and authority of Central Administrative Tribunal. The lordships have, my lord? Page 11. Kindly, my lord, directly come to page 12, the explanation. For those who are acting or functioning in the affairs of the Union, there is a Central Administrative Tribunal. For those who are in the state, there is a State Administrative Tribunal. Para page 12, explanation. For the removal of doubts, it is hereby declared that reference to Union in this subsection shall be construed as including reference also to a Union territory. Even their service disputes go before the Central Administrative Tribunal dealing with officers working in the affairs of the Union and not, my lord, anywhere else. That's, my lord, the purpose. Now, my lord, establishment of High Court of Delhi. Bottom of page 12.
Yes.
Page 13. There is yet another clear indication that the Constitution treats Union, Union Territory and UPSC on one hand, and the State and State Public Service Commission on the other. Article 241, which is a part of Part 8, that is under the heading Union Territories, It is under this provision that Parliament has made Delhi High Court Act 1966. Article 219, read with Section 4 of the Delhi High Court Act, replaces the word governor with lieutenant governor. Wherever the Parliament wanted, the Parliament has made a provision for governor and lieutenant governor. Please, now, my lord, kindly directly come to page 15. And this is, my lord, the heart of the matter, which your lord, which would be troubling your lordship's conscience also, because a very well orchestrated perception is that we don't have any power. What do we do? My learned friend argued that we don't have steering wheel, we don't have gears in our hands, we don't have brake, we don't have clutch. Now kindly see, my lord, in that context, and I'll answer, my lord, that question. At the outset, my lord, paragraph 39, and this is, my lord, kindly see, my lord, there are two types of control. My lord, what the central government is claiming is control for recruitment, appointment, and posting. Nothing else. Rest governance is with the elected wing. And I'll show that. Kindly see. At the outset, it may be pointed out that there is a clear distinction of legislative powers and consequent administrative powers with regard to Union of India and NCT of Delhi. They are functional control and administrative control. Functional control means right to have steering wheel, right to have gears, right to have brake, right to have clutch under their control. So far as the functional control is concerned, it signifies the control of an elected body in its functioning through the officers and employees working in the affairs of the union. That is, day-to-day functioning under the administrative control and supervision of the minister of the concerned department, the Honorable Chief Minister, and the Council of Ministers, that is elected wing. But as my Lord the Chief Justice of India suggested, even in those cases where it is the central entity, suppose under 239AA they are entitled, they can function. The officers will be answerable to the Minister, the Honorable Chief Minister, and the Council of Ministers, not to anybody else. Please see. So far as the administrative control is concerned, it would signify the decision as to whom to be posted in affairs of the NCT of Delhi, in which position and post such officers or employees would be posted, transfers to be effected, and disciplinary action to be taken. This control is absolutely necessary since Delhi is the capital and the central control is not only desirable but constitutionally permitted without in any way interfering with the absolute functional control of the elected wing. In case of NCT of Delhi, as explained here under in detail, the functional control vests in the elected wing and all officers, employees are required to function under the administrative control and supervision of the elected wing and implementing the programs and policies of the elected wing, which would reflect the wish and will of the electorate, while the administrative control is vested both constitutionally and under and other in the president and under the order of the president. Kindly allow me to make, who exercises the same through the lieutenant governor. So far as the control is concerned, almost a fiction is created by way of a public perception that they have absolutely no control of the elected government over the officers and employees working in GNCPD. This fictional perception and far from truth, which will become evident from the following paragraphs. Lord, kindly see. In conformity, Lord, your office can skip 44. Lord, I'm not taking your office time. Crucial is 45 onwards.
Mr. Mehta, to be on the absolutely lighter side, nothing to do. When you said that functional powers and the administrative powers and the driving seat, correct, clutch, everything is with them. But according to them, correct, the direction, like GPS, correct, the direction where to go, left side, it is with the central government.
Lord, after reading, Lord,
that is what, this is a distinction between the administrative power and the functional power.
No.
Correct?
I will not respect.
Suppose, according to them, if they want to go straight, they cannot go because of the administrative power, because the direction will be go right side or left side.
Lord, after going through this,
absolute lighter, nothing.
Yeah, I know. Sometimes it's good, Lord, to have lighter moments. But after going through this, I can say this, Lord, in this very simile, Dr. Singh, we say, they have the steering wheel, they have the gears, They have the clutch. They have the brake. They decide the direction also. Only the make of tires, whether MRF or CN, is done by the LG. And if still you cannot drive, then there is something seriously wrong with your driving ability. Not with selection of tires.
But you know, Mr. Mehta, actually, see, as we know in the States, for instance, the most important part is where do you post an officer, right? Whether an officer will be in Secretary Finance, Secretary Home, Secretary Education, Secretary Environment, Secretary Youth Affairs or Sports,
etc.
So what you're saying is that, look, we will post you as Secretary Finance. Once you are posted as Secretary of Finance, you will act under the jurisdiction of the Minister of Finance. We will post you as Secretary of Education. Then you will be reportable to the, you will report only to the Secretary, to the Minister for Education and the Delhi government. But suppose they find that somebody is not really up to, you know, not functioning as effectively as in that particular role. Your contention is, of course, Dr. Singhvi also conceded that we are not a disciplinary jurisdiction. But they cannot even switch officers.
They can. I'll answer your lordship's question. And my lord, kindly park that question till your lordship goes through this. I'm saying this with a sense of responsibility. They can always say that this man is not fit for the health ministry, post it in industries ministry. They have to send a letter through LG to the MHA, and it is never refused.
That's a matter of, you know, that's a matter of accommodation and practice.
Kindly, my lord, otherwise, look at it from that this question. Way. Kindly, park.
An officer knows that, well, I cannot be moved out from this position at all. I cannot be moved out as an excise commissioner. However, I do. Unless I have a green signal from MHA.
Kindly, my lord, kindly park really,
as an I whatever I do as an excise commissioner, what I do as a secretary of education.
Unfortunately,
unless I have the green signal, I will never be moved out.
Lord, unfortunately.
Will that not dilute even the functional control? That's the point. Yes, recruitment, disciplinary control. You're right, absolutely. Dr. Singhvi, in fact, didn't go as far as that when you made a very nuanced.
I hope, my lord, these are tentative
about posting. Subjective. Question is about posting. You see that?
Lord, sometimes a wrong perception repeatedly and carefully orchestrated through various mediums, lord, have the tendency of entering our minds. Lord, the following paragraphs.
All right, quickly, let's read it.
Para 45.
And, my lord, why this is relevant and why your lordship may park that, my lord, apprehension, tentative apprehension, all till right. Your lordship, my lord, goes through.
All right, let's quickly read that para 40.
First, all India service officers, Delhi officers, and all other officers working for GNCTD are under the functional control of minister concerned. The Honorable Chief Minister and GNCTD and Council of Ministers, as pointed out here under. Second, for any officer, the most important element of his service is career progression in terms of promotion, which is based upon the annual performance appraisal report. Please don't not make any conclusion till I take your lordship through this one fully. Any adverse entry in APA, that is annual performance appraisal, is capable of spoiling his chances of promotion and his future career progression. So far as this all senior and middle level officers are concerned, who are under the functional control of the elected government and through whom the will and wish of the electorate in terms of the programs and policies of the governments are to be implemented, their APAR are under direction control of the Honorable Chief Minister of Delhi, either as reporting authority, reviewing authority, or accepting authority. In other words, depending upon the functions of each senior level and middle level officers under the supervision and control of the ministers of each department, which includes right from secretary, chief secretary, etc., right from secretary downwards, the Honorable Chief Minister can give suitable grades which will have a direct bearing on his future career progression. APAR consists of annual work plan to be decided twice a year. Now, this answers your lordship's question. That is, once at the start of the financial year, and secondly, by way of a mid-year review. The assessment of officers in APAR is done on following attributes. This the elected with the wing does. Assessment of work output. You cannot say, Lord, I have said efficiency. This man should be efficient in this field and not in that field. Kindly see, it consists of following sub-attributes. Accomplishment of planned work. Quality of output. Accomplishment of exceptional work or unforeseen task performance. Then second, the 30% weighted, assessment of personal attributes. It consists of following sub-attributes, attitude to work, sense of responsibility, overall bearing and personality, emotional stability, communication skills, moral courage and willingness to take a professional stand, leadership qualities, captaincy to work in time limit, capacity to work in time limit. Then another third, 30%, assessment of functional competency. It consists of following sub-attributes, knowledge of laws, rules, procedures, IT skills, and awareness of local norms in the relevant area. Strategic planning ability, decision-making ability, initiative, coordination ability, ability to motivate and develop subordinates or work in a team. All these attributes are decided and gradation is given by the Honorable Chief Minister. Kindly report further. It is submitted that Honorable CM appraised the performance of officers of GNCTD through the mechanism of APAR, wherein the performance of officers of the GNCTD is evaluated by the CM, i.e. elected government, on a scale of 0, that is worst, to 10, best, and also a pen picture on conduct of these officers are recorded in writing by the Honorable CM in these APARs. I, as an officer, cannot say that I owe my allegiance to MHA. I will not take orders from you because he is the one who is writing my annual performance appraisal report. In the last 3 years, that is 2019-20, 2021, 21-22, the Honorable CM had appreciated the work of all IAS officers, principal secretaries, secretaries and heads of the department working in GNCTD and accorded them outstanding rating. Grading from 8 and above is outstanding, not out of 10. To all officers except one officer wherein very good grading was given to such officer for the year 2019 to 20. Even this officer has been graded as an outstanding officer for the year 2021 and 21-22 by the Honorable CM. Details of Honorable CM, details of which are mentioned in a, kindly come to page 43. For my satisfaction, please come to page 43. But if I am not working satisfactorily, if I am not fit for that particular post, if I am not listening to the ministers, if I am not discharging my functions properly, if I say that I owe my allegiance somewhere else, then Manod, it directly reflects Manod, on my APR, which is not to be written by the central government or even by the LG. Kindly see Manod, page 43. I'll not read Manod, everything, just Manod, have a glance. Mr. So-and-so, ACS power, grading 10 out of 10. So-and-so, ACS UD and director, local bodies, 10 out of 10. Then 9, 9, 9.5, 8, 9.50, 9.80, 8.50, etc., etc. Manod, everyone, kindly come to 45. Manod, this is the next year, 2021. These are the people working under their supervision, under their control, under their administration, discharging the duties given by them, and they judge them. Manod, please see 9, 9.5, 9.5, 8.
Between Manod's pleadings and written submissions seems to have been obliterated. My learned friends repeated saying about not going into facts seems to have been obliterated.
No, this is
written submissions are having facts, no pleadings, and your lordship is to be drawn in, whether in a lighter way, not so light way. Well, our allegation is central government is trying to swallow our powers. What is happening today is my entire morning time is going to be swallowed by my learned.
Lord, I would, my Lord, give one full, many credits to Dr. Singhvi, but today, right now, one credit, he interjected at a right time from his point of view. If this was the time where he should have interjected and derailed the argument. I refuse to be derailed.
Solicitor, I remember one day, when Dr. Singhvi, you know, with his characteristic flourish came in the morning for mentioning matters before just Narasimhanmi and said, I'm filing an affidavit. Please ask the solicitor.
Your lordship refused.
We refused that. We said, you're not going to go into
it. And repeatedly, he's protesting that I will not do it.
All right, but what we are not going to be impacted by it. He's just sort of said that
That's all right.
Individual.
No, that also is taken.
Individual gradings.
They can refuse that this is a false figure.
But no, no, but Mr. Solicitor, we got your basic, we'll look at it at a doctrinal level that the APARs are written by the Chief Minister. You may make that limited point. Let's not go into.
Kindly, my lord, come to page.
Anyway, you want to point out.
Because then you have a whole lot of material in the joint.
Your supposition is that apprehension is not well founded, correct? That though officers are not properly working, correct? Nothing can be done. That is what your supposition.
Yes, I'm respectful. I'm very.
Because ultimately, you say the supposition is done by the Chief Minister.
Nothing inconvenient will come. You can sit.
I'm saying nothing. I'm just.
No, you right.
You are the one who's speaking.
Lord, another thing. I'm answering your lordship's apprehension that what if the person is not fit for that job? Then, my lord, kindly see page 47. This is not facts. This is a form, format, standard format. Standard format. What is the matter in which, my lord, what are the issues on which he is to be judged by the.
In the APRs, right? Annual performance. All right, now let's go on to the next point, Mr.
We'll now go on to para. This job, etc., etc., not competent.
Now let's read para 59. Doesn't